first thing you want to do is provide for yourself, provide for your own needs, your garden and your animal systems, your water systems, provide for yourself, your family, and even help your local community get going before you worry about the wilderness, because the wilderness has been destroyed by exploitation for people at a distance where it wasn't needed. We can produce the same amount of nutrition globally that industrial agriculture produces on 4 to 6% of the equivalent area. So I didn't say nutrition, not food, nutrition. And the equivalent area, but it needs to be positioned near where we live, either in urban or perimeter urban agriculture and outside of that rangeland and forestry. So if you look at what the production is on small gardens compared to agriculture, and the waste on agriculture and the energy of transport on agriculture and how much crop actually doesn't make it to the consumer, we're way in front. So a lot of that inappropriate agricultural land we're going to have to abandon if we're going to be truly sustainable, and it'll have to go back to wilderness. Now, it'll go back on its own over a period of time. Some landscape is totally devastated and it's dysfunctional and it'll take a long time. So once we're looking after ourselves, we're going to have an obligation to go and put some landscapes back into function. And we're going to have to sort out the water systems to slow down water and rehydrate the landscape and put it back into natural vegetation covers and biomass. So we're going to have to create humus in the soil, and it starts off by good water design. So going out and slowing down water, mitigating erosion, stopping erosion and soaking water in and taking that soakage up with vegetation systems. And then it starts to rehabilitate on its own.